we pass out the awards for the games, let's remember the real reason we're here. Grandma Hilda's, who would have guessed she'd live this long, 85th birthday. Now let's have a moment of silence to reflect on all she's meant to us.
This is gonna hurt you more than it's gonna hurt me, Perry the Platypus. Fire! Oh, look at you! You're Bruni the Dehydropus! I wonder what.
Just brush it out, toss your head back, and voila! It's simplicious!
It's not simplicious! It's hard pleasure!
Candace, take it easy!
Look at me! A tragic victim of internet hairstylists!
Sorry, I don't think there's anything I can do, but there are a couple of guys who could.
No! No way!
Behold the dull and boring Nathan! Yes, you made it a platypus!
Wow, who knew? Sure hope it didn't hit an innocent civilian.
Why aren't they doing anything? I've got a golden opportunity here, and I don't want to blow it!
Hey, buddy. Are you busy?
No, not really.
You don't know, Norm, it occurs to me that though I've never had a son, there is someone I can always count on to be there. Someone I've begun to think of as family.
Yes?
And that someone is Perry the Platypus. See you around, junk pile.
Apology accepted, Dad.
He with tears in his eyes, he said, Mr. Trucker Man, you done saved Christmas.
Oh, that's good.
Mom, bust, boys.
Oh, Lawrence, look. Candace is sleep busting again.
Oh, that's adorable.
Hun, go back to your nap now. Go on.
Mom, bust,
boys. Oh, go on, play track three. It's the one where a group of truckers take down a corrupt police force using only their trucks and their saucy colloquialisms.
Of course, you'll only need this if you're attacked by one of the royals or a member of parliament, so it's probably okay to leave the safety on. And here's your brand new rocket car. Sweet, huh? Good luck, Agent P.
Carl, did you tell him the accelerator's a little touchy?
I think he knows, sir.
3, 2, 1. Service. Power is vitals.
Wait, let me try something. Platyborg, do the same thing to those two boys. What?
What? Perry?
Yes! I knew it! Wait a minute, I'm confused.
Order. The sun is shining.
It's noticeably warmer.
It's summer. Every single moment is worth its weight in gold.
Keep it open for as long as possible, but the window is very unstable. Even the slightest disturbance will cause it to collapse. Like that, for instance.
Hey, Candace.
You guys are so... Wait, where are the four of you?
Oh, these guys are from Vistamin.
Are we inside the mysterious force?
I'm not sure I understand the
and
question.
Why is Isabella suddenly fashionable?
What do you mean suddenly?
Seriously, where are we?
Candace, I'm sure you have a million questions, but right now...
Boom! Wow! If I had a nickel for every time I was doomed by a puppet, I'd have 2 nickels, which isn't a lot, but it's weird that it happened twice, right? Welcome, doomed guests! Come on, keep trudging! Doom is right away!
Thank you.
Oh, that she remembers.
Mike, wait.
Psst. Mom!
Candace, what are you doing here?
You gotta come outside and bust the boys.
I'm not leaving now. The girl is about to forgive the guy for the cliche misunderstanding. Well, after she battles these robots.
Whoa, this 3D is amazing.
Hey, I just wanted to say thanks for telling us all about summer, you know, opening our horizons, and teaching Ferb classical guitar. Hey, it's our Perry. Perry! Looks like the evil was fried right out of him. Sorry he's mostly made of metal now. Are you kidding? That makes him extra cool. Let's
respond to that. I think I will be continuing with the race now.
Dropping out seems like the easy way, but years from now, I don't want you to look back and wonder, what if?
Out of my way, turkey!
Why does everybody think I'm a turkey?
So, Perry the Platypus, let me tell you about my latest scheme. The other day, I was perusing the internet when I came upon an online auction for a Super Multi-Inator. I wasn't even sure what it did, but you know, Super Multi-Inator was my grandmother's.
That's better. Huh. I guess that is pretty scary. That guy should not be holding that wombat so close to his face.
Candace Platypus, why are you doing this to me? Get it? Wire? Because I mean, why? Ah, come on. Now, I know I'm defeated, but at least I got a good joke out of it. Show me some love.
When this giant version of the classic game Skiddlywiffers...
Wait, did you say Skiddlywiffers?
Giant Skiddlywiffers, yes.
Giant Skiddlywiffers? That is so bustable! And yet, so tempting. And yet, so bustable! And yet, so tempting.
Wanna play?
Yes, I'm the seeker!
I got dibs on the truck!
Booyah!
I claim the fedora, and Ferb picks the nose.
It's dangerous out here, Perry the Platypus, and I should know. You see, back in Gimmelstump in my youth, when I was camping, I had this incident with a swarm of bees. I only got one sting, but it did a lot of damage. I still have a hydrant stuck in my leg, see? I'd have it removed, but the doctors say it's too close to an artery to operate. That kind of thing happens all the time in the woods. All right, maybe I'm overreacting. Actually, it's really just a beautiful pastoral setting. There's probably nothing to fear.
Woo! 13 wins in a row! Yeah, baby! Ding, ding, ding! A victory bell!
Nice game, Candace.
Yeah, for me! I totally creamed you guys in that game, and now I'm gonna bust you for it. Mom! 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 Hey, look what Phineas and Ferb built!
You're right, Candace. Call the authorities. It's a cube.
No time for sarc...
You dweeb, such a soccer ball. This is a football.
Actually, there's no one who loves soccer more than my brother Ferb. Ferb got all of us into playing, and we've gotten pretty good if I do say so myself. But Ferb, he's the real master.
Yeah, I once saw Ferb play an entire game of soccer using a pumpkin. And he didn't even break it. To this day, his motivation...
As for Football X7, is it possible, perhaps, one day, someone, some young dreamer with remarkable building and creative skills might just make Professor Rossi Fop's dream come true? No, not a chance. Don't be ridiculous. It's impossible.
Impossible? The only thing that's impossible is impossibility. Now, Ferb and I believe we've figured out where Professor E-Forp went wrong.
Oi! Are you actually saying you're gonna build that here?
Yes, we are gonna do what no one has ever done before. Play.
You asked me to teach you how to be proper and sophisticated for Jeremy.
But...
Right, I can do this.
Good girl.
The first lesson for a lady in training is about posture. Honestly, I'm not quite sure why this is, but from birth, all proper ladies are warned that they must stand and sit completely vertically straight, and even the tiniest bend or deviation on...
Don't worry, you guys. If I know my brother, he'll come through for us. Ferb?
Hi, guys. I brought some dry ice.
Aww.
Oh, and I brought Ferb, too.
Ferb!
Ferb, you came to play.
As long as my team will have me, curse and all.
Of course we will. It's not about winning. It's about the joy of the game.
Actually, it's about winning.
He's not. You're Wilson.
Got it. Oh, hey, AD, how about one last little event?
Keepy-uppy?
Keepy-uppy. Are you mad? I have never lost a game of keepy-uppy in my life.
Well, you won't mind humouring me then.
Now I'm going to activate my...
No! Yes!
It missed the goal by a mile.
What happened? I guess the curse wasn't broken.
No, it's broken. Sometimes you just miss.
Hello.
It's the sniffing.
I'm supervising. All right, here we go. Elevation, 33 degrees. 3, 2, 1.
Have fun.
Hi, Isabella.
Hi, Mrs. Flynn Fletcher.
With our current velocity and wind resistance, we should be nearing the target in no time. Whoops, better retract the launch mechanism.
If you want to see evil tonight at its best, we're the cruelest of people, put us to the test. If you're looking for heinous and iniquitous acts, ethics cannot contain us, sit back and relax.
One of these cats will be our villainous star.
So without further ado, here they are.
It has come to our attention that Lawrence Fletcher from your host family has somehow entered the Love Muffin Supreme Ruler pageant. Of course, considering his genial nature, a win for him would really stretch my suspension of disbelief. But just in case, you better sit tight and just observe.
Remember, points will be awarded by the audience, so get out your voting boxes. Our first evil event, the Mechanical Mother.
You broke my eyes.
Inator.
You shot.
Excuse us, we're here to take this thing away.
What? No!
Sorry, kid, we got a work order right here.
No! No!
And now the final event.
I think that's Dad.
What was the topic of his lecture again?
Hi, Dad.
Herb, what are you doing here?
Brilliant shot, by the way.
It's all about little adjustments. You'd think we would have noticed it.
I'm gonna give those orange peanuts a second look.
What's that?
Hi, I'm Russell. I live here.
Oh, Russell, like the leaves.
What are you trying to do, scare us?
No, hiding in the leaves makes me feel warm and secure. Relatively speaking.
Why do you not?
Strange, howling at the moon, graffiti at every leather shop in the tri-state area, and we don't know what to make of this crop circle. Get to the bottom of it, Agent P.
Get to the bottom of it, Agent P.
That's not how I sound, Carl.
That's not how I sound, Carl.
Come on, most of the ghosts are this way.
Good, let's bust them and hit the road. I'm missing Jeremy's party.
There are no monsters in America. What a genius.
Get ready for utter terror. Cause you're just some cub that he's gonna chew. And you never had a steak any rarer. So you better beware of the moon. Cause we gotta wear cats.
Locals are advised to stay off their lawns.
Forget that. I say we get him!
Yeah!
Wait a minute. You brought a torch on our date?
Hello, pitchfork.
Where am I? How did... What's that awful taste in my mouth? And when did they do all this beautiful landscaping? Oh, no! Oh, Barry the Platypus, thank goodness you're here. Quickly, we have to get me back to my lab before I moo again. Or my...
Yeah, blah, 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 love fest. Some of us have somewhere to be.
Yeah, but before we go, how about one more trick?
Well,
mob of angry ghosts chasing a werecow. How do you do it?
The hideous light of the day star!
Where did that wind come from?
Oops, sorry. I opened the window. It was getting stuffy in here.
That was the best movie ever.
Yeah, I know. Imagine if you had to choose between a bloodthirsty, undead, walking corpse and a slobbering, hairy lupine man-beast for a boyfriend. What could possibly be cooler?
Doofenshmirtz Sable Incorporated!
Harry the Platypus, didn't you get my letter?
Of course not. Here, I'll read it to you.
Dear Perry the Platypus, I know Major Monogram will ignore my letter and send you to stop me. That's why you are now trapped. Best wishes, your nemesis, Heinz. Come to think of it, it wouldn't have made much sense until now.
Okay, Ferb, let's run through the list. To fulfill Isabella's request, we've rigged a super bright grow light to intermittently go on and off as Bambina needs it. Next, Baljeet's request to lift heavy objects accomplished by using gravity counteracting barbells. Check.
I am so happy! I have just torn my rotator cuff!
Buford's request to float in the air using levitation air jets in the lawn.
Now I can look down.
Yeah, my dad said I could drive it, just as long as I didn't get a scratch on it. Oh, my dad's gonna kill me!
Why, dude? It's not scratched.
Jeremy!
Oh, hey, Candace. Did you come to pick up your MP3 player?
Huh? No! Have you seen my brothers?
Sure, yeah, they were just here. They went home to look for you.
Oh, no! Villagers!
Oh, Candace, that was just some stuff we made for our friends. You're not a vampire. Look, I'll prove it. See? The sun has absolutely no effect on you. Ferb, we're gonna need a dustpan and some glue.
When you have to buy your undead things from Danville's One Golf Store.
That's okay. You guys can stay out here and be the cheering section with Candace.
Must pass for Nathan, Ferb.
But what if you do not come out?
If we're not out in 15 minutes, you can smash the machine and rescue us, just like in the old days.
Sounds like a party.
Ferb, start the timer, please.
Synchronizing watches.
Women and children and the faint of heart may wish to leave now. So we bid you adieu. Goodbye. I'll be there.
Put on your coats and stay a while.
Straight jackets. Classic. Ready? Okay, shake me out. Awesome. This is gonna be fun. I don't know, Ferb. I think we should file this under Dungeon Escape.
Well, here we are.
Okay, dude, don't show off.
I used to get stuck on the simplest of things. I never tried flying or spreading my wings. What I want to convey is that I'm getting away. Cause tonight I'm breaking out.
Do and only one thing. That's some. Show we just put on, isn't it, Madam Mayor?
What the?
You see, your wonderful mayor and I agreed in the limousine to put on this little play for your edification.
No!
Look at me. I've got friends all over the earth.
All right, then.
In fact, we even have an alien friend named Meep. He's from another planet, so really we have friends all over the galaxy.
A small matter for one such as me. You will never escape. Never!
That works for me.
Well, the only...
Do-do-day. We're gonna use the DNA in this potato chip to clone our own potatoes. Hey, where's Perry?
Good morning, Agent P. We recently learned that Doofenshmirtz has fallen behind on his electrical bills. This seems odd, considering his generous alimony package. His ex-wife, Charlene, is loaded. And I might add, quite a handsome woman. No, not that I...
And how will I acquire the Spartan army gone low these many millennia? With my historical army retrievenator! It's potato-powered because I spent this month's alimony check on my last inator. You remember that, the made of gold inator. And, you know, I wore out 3 pairs of shoes buying up all these potatoes, but on the good side, it smells like French...
...while the rest of us simultaneously round up the spud spawn. Hey, wait. Ferb, isn't simultaneously on our list of S-words seldom used by kids? Awesome.
See? Isn't this fun?
Thrilling. What? Mom, look! Potato, gremlins! And Phineas and Ferb!
Potato gremlins? Can...
Wait a minute. I got an idea. Hello, folks! I'm Mr. Sock! Hey! Who turned out the lights? Thanks! You stink! Well, that wasn't very nice.
Technically, we are socks.
Hey, Mr. The Sock! What are you doing here?
Just looking.
For what?
My soulmate.
If I were dangling from a ledge, he'd surely save me with a wedgie.
I'm smart, perhaps a bit refined.
And I'm a bit more edgy.
Frenemies, he's like my least favorite brother. We both have our roles, this is a symbiotic relationship. Cause we're frenemies, we like disliking one another. Yes, we're frenemies, he's like my least favorite brother. You and I, we're not enemies or friends, we're just frenemies to the end.
Ruined? That was the best time we've had since they canceled Three Bean Salad Tuesdays. The floor show was fantastic.
Really?
The ending was a bit out there, but trust me, they had us at sock puppets.
Form a line, people. Form a line.
Well, it's too bad we couldn't get the potatoes for the latkes, but I'd say everything worked out fine. What's Perry doing in a pillory? I couldn't agree more. That was some nice gesturing, Ferb. Do some more. Ah, I know what we're going to do, spatula. Oh, today. I really should have known that from the context. Oh, here's another one. Hey, where's spatula?
Would you like to try it?
I'm gonna go with no, but thank you.
Well, you should still try to relax.
Mom, I don't need to relax. I need to bust Phineas and Ferb.
Well, listen, sweetie, you said so yourself. They're just plotting, right? That gives you plenty of time to go to the mall before they start implementing.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Maybe... Hey, wait a second. Are you making fun of me?
Maybe just a little.
She's right. I probably have plenty of time to go to the mall.
Stop looking at me. I am not going to do jazz hands, even though you have totally earned it.
How do you say goodbye?
When you say goodbye, you blow a raspberry. Let's all do it.
All I have to do is speak my evil message into this microphone. Slap yourself. Push this button and... Whatever I say comes printed out on a leaflet. It's gonna work. I'm using a very convincing font. It's bold and it has a lot of serifs.
Serifs are semi-structural details which...
Oh, for crying out loud, Norm. Listen, here's a buck. Why don't you go get out of here and get a haircut or something?
Out I go.
Norm, take...
Of every word, you move it to the end and then say herb. It's like we're adding a phonetic boost to it. Don't get confused, just get used to it.
Whenever someone sneezes, you no longer say bless you. Instead, you play a flugelhorn and give him your left shoe.
Whenever you meet someone...
Oh, great. Nice haircut, by the way. Where's my change? You're a weird robot, Norm.
Ankhthurb Ooyerb.
Oh, is that Swedish? You better not be broken, Norm. You still have to fly around the city and distribute leaflets. But I guess as long as you remember the code for takeoff, we'll
Launchlerb?
Be... No, it's not Launchlerb. Talk normal. It's launch! Launch! No, no, not yet! Not yet! Wait.
Oh.
Curse you, Manny
the Blossom! Earwerp, oinger, pounder!
Knock it off with the double talk. I can't stand it! Talk normal!
Talk normal.
Ah, summer. Sunny, warm, some might say hot. It sure would be nice to cool off for a bit. Any ideas? Well, while a visit to Antarctica does sound cool, I was thinking of a traditional family Christmas special.
All right, people, let's move it in.
Got some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low.
Sorry, H&P. Carl's an extra in some Christmas show, and I don't know what Doof is doing today. You know what? I'm just going to send you over there blind. Good luck.
Mom, Phineas and Ferb were making Christmas in July.
Well, isn't that cute?
Do you happen to be standing near a television?
I think there's a whole wall of them behind me.
Would you turn around and look at the TVs?
Okay.
Tonight's special is brought to you by the good folks at...
Any of you. For some reason, Christmas seems to have snuck up on me this year, and I'm a bit behind on my shopping. But I have a solution. The Transportinator! To instantly transport me to the stores while everyone else is circling around looking for a parking spot. It's not exactly evil, but it's slightly unfair. Let the last minute shopping be-
The words were by an English guy, the music Scandinavian. Wenceslas was 5'6", he kept his face unshaven. Though just a duke throughout his life, he always ruled so justly. His kingly title was conferred upon him posthumously.
Well, I stand corrected. You seem to have a lot of information. But if you know so much about it, why do you not sing the original song?
I like my version better. It's about me.
Hey, look, everybody. It's Perry. We're all together after all. This is the best Christmas ever.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Give to Agents A through Z. Carl, get away from that punch bowl. I'm saving that for me.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a New Year.
I wish for a calculator slash him the English translator.
How come the reverse switch works for Perry the Platypus, but not me?
Hey, boys. I heard you were doing Christmas in July.
Yes, yes.
And I bought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow. Oh, let it snow, let it snow.
May, Boofgard and Baljug.
Waka chuka.
Boofgard.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. So they're just going to be talking in cave talk?
Yeah, and I think Doofenshmirtz is just going to grunt.
Well, how are people going to know what's going on?
Well, periodically, we'll just cut to you and me explaining it just like this, in this sort of photo animation.
Why don't we just film?
Abu Gabudar.
Abu Gabudar. Dondu Parkish Dog.
Tankuda. Akua.
Kawadar. Chakalaka! Kantok! Digaraba oj!
Mug! Can talk in charka?
Ah, Kantok. Yar in charka.
Bunkalong, bunkalong, bunkalonga!
Huh? Quank.
Give me the pen. So Finnebunk and Gerb have already invented the wheel, and they're getting ready to show their friends.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Ah! Ta-da! Ta-da-da-da!
Finnebug and Gerb, Gunga Bunga, Dua! 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 Dua!
A wah?
Ni Kantok, Laka Waka.
Kantok, Enthusalaka.
Kantok, Bunga Laka.
May Gantok.
May Cherubunk.
Finnebunk and Gerb! Bunker.
Mog bust a Finnabunk and Gerb. Mog, Mog!
Ah! Kantok make a foomfa!
Foomfa?
Kantok make a foomfa!
Ah! Kantok make a foomfa! Kantok and Chaka!
Ah, bonka!
Relax, everyone. Ferb and I devised a solution. Hop on.
Phineas and Ferb, with technology that's slightly more advanced than what we have today.
Mom, you're doing it again.
It helps my arches.
Look, guys, it's Regent Monogram, and that girl must be Princess Isabella.
Regent Monogram.
Doofus Khan, why that impertinent? A taunting scroll? How uncouth.
Shall I order the final attack, sir?
No, no, General Carla. A full-scale attack now would put the princess at risk. Oh, if only Master Perry had not given up the way of the warrior and gone to live a contemplative life on the unclimbable mountain of unclimbableness. He could
to avoid that. Must have forgot that one. Oops. Oh, that's right. You're supposed to skip this step and... it's under control, honey. Testing the system. Oh, yeah, it works. Anyway, here you are. You'll find a nice rack to sleep on and some rats to keep you company. So while you're here, enjoy your stay.
Oh, that'll do.
Eviscerating fish. Though I suppose here in China we just call them eviscerating fish.
Oh, but here we just call them eviscerating fish.
So how do we get up the unclimbable mountain of unclimbableness?
No worries, Buford. I think we have just the thing.
Oh, come on!
But why, Master Perry? What made you give up the life of a warrior hero? What's he doing?
That's a ripple dissolve. He must be having a flashback.
Does he know we can't see it? Should we give him some privacy? I don't know the protocol for flashbacks. Is he back? He's back. Well, judging by the time you spent staring...
Make you a warrior, even though now you're a wuss. It's the way of the platypus.
But that's just the general information. Here's some of the specific things you can look forward to in your workout.
You're gonna run up a ramp for 2 buckets of water. Swing over mud for some reason.
Are you sure you won't go with us, Master Perry? The kingdom really needs you back.
He's doing it again.
Goodbye, Perry.
Where are they? You know I can't see anything, right?
Follow my lead when we get there. How did you guys defeat all these soldiers?
We're okay.
There was nothing to it.
No time for flashbacks. We have to go.
What flashback? I'm just rippling. It relaxes me.
Oh, would you look at that? A bunch of kids running away with the prince. Running away with the princess? Oh, time to take matters into my own hands. Time for a little remodeling.
We can't take much more of this. What should we do?
Surrender! Oh, what now? A giant terracotta warrior, roughly the same size as my dragon!
Left leg, right leg.
What could he possibly want? Oh, look, he's doing that crane thing. Oh, poor baby, feeling tired, huh? Allow me to put you to sleep!
Ew, who puts armpit hair on a mechanical dragon?
Next time, don't put your wind-up key in such an obvious place. I cleverly hid mine in a spot only an ancient warrior would dare to go. No! Perry the platypus!
Well, all's well that ends well.
Perhaps one day we'll devise a way to keep our fair land safe from barbarian invaders.
You know, I bet these blocks would make a great wall.
Ferb, I know what we're gonna do tomorrow.
Well, that took longer than expected.
But it is a great...
The way of the platypus!
Well, how are we doing today, Major? Feeling better?
Carl, what are you doing here?
Your wife said it'd be okay if I came up here and kept you company. Would that be all right? I brought a book.
What kind of book?
It's a fantasy adventure with wizards and knights.
Are there woodland sprites?
Well, there's water.
Be my stout winged messenger.
That should catalyze it. We'll add it to our inventory of magical elixirs. What say we try a couple of these out? Cool,
Bad sweet mother will be herald to your Ember Pride. I can't talk like this anymore. You guys are so busted. Mom! Yak!
I don't know about you, Ferbalot, but I didn't get any of that. Hey, there's something fishy about this rain. It's unearthly. Come on, we'd better get inside.
Behold! And to you, Ferbalot and Phineas, I bid thee good fortune.
Wow, good thing she wasn't Lady of the Hot Coffee. Mom, Ferb and I are going on a quest.
Don't forget to goad the geese on your way out.
Sure thing, Mom. Get in there, Gertrude. Whoa, this must be the sprite, Isabel.
What art thou doing?
Apparently you're going to guide us on a quest.
Yes, you must first cross the raging river.
The tempest we were experiencing was conjured up by the evil Malefishmertz. We need you to fly up to his fortress and put the kibosh on his evil machinations. I really like that character. Is there going to be more about him?
I'm sorry, sir. He just comes in at the beginning. Shall I continue? Huh?
Okay.
Meanwhile, back at the cottage of the humble and...
Ah! Oh, great, a tail! Phineas and Ferbalot, you are so... I can't go to the Midsummer's Road Gathering Harvest bonfire like this. What will Jeremiah think? I'm just going to have to find Phineas and Ferbalot and make them tell me which one of these elixirs will change me back. Oh, this is not... Oh, no.
He protects my garden from witches' spells and wood trolls. I'm gonna make small versions of him and sell them all over. Anyway, let me tell you about my plan for seizing control of the Tri-Kingdom area. You see, I was bullfrog hunting down by the ratcatcher's shack and came across the biggest raspberry I had ever seen. It was the size of a cucumber. Is what I said because I had a gag over my mouth. Yeah, don't say it. I know, they're a little small, but that's why the rain, see? They absorb water, and they will grow, and when they get bigger, I'm hoping their attitude will become a little more, you know, rampagey.
Isabel, why did you take us to the Inn of the Prancing Platypus?
We need allies. There's a lot of mercenaries and thugs to choose from. Plus, they make a great taco salad.